Instructions in the dressing room. Remember, obey my commands at all time. Defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Let's do it. Touch gloves.
So as you heard that from our MC Craig Stephen, this is 10 3-minute rounds for the WBC International Bantamweight title. That's Ryan Burnett. He is the champion. He won this on the Carl Frampton-Scott Quigg undercard back in February, beating Anthony Sartor.
Seconds out.
Put Sartor down in a fifth round, but couldn't manage to stop him. Won every single round. Previous fight to that, won the British title against Jason Booth. Again, won every round. So he's coming on a pace under Adam Booth. And these kind of matchups are always interesting because we know a lot about Burnett, but we know very little about Ramirez. It's the first time he's been outside Mexico. Record of 12 wins, 2 defeats. All of those wins have come in his local area down on the Pacific coast. The defeats, well, one came against Alejandro Gonzalez, the same man who put Carl Frampton over a couple of times on Frampton's American debut. He was thrown in very deep with him. Gonzalez 16-0-2 at the time, and it was just Ramirez's fourth professional fight, and just very difficult to glean anything from his record, Paul. We'll just have to quite simply have a look and see what happens.
It is, and it would have probably been the case before YouTube for most fighters out there, but you know now we have the luxury of YouTube, and even if you don't know much about a fighter, you can still see a couple of clips about him. But you know, Burnett first round, usually as a fear and out stage, he will have studied a couple of tapes, and you'd have to be pretty hardcore to know a lot about Ramirez.
Ramirez is trying to keep that upper body moving. Started boxing at 20, which in Mexican terms is pretty late, really. They got here on Sunday and have been acclimatizing since, haven't really done too much, just ticking over. Fight week, of course, there's not all that much really to be done. He expects to stop Burnett, was what he said to me yesterday via his translator. They knew a bit about Burnett, though. They know about his amateur pedigree. They know that he is a rated fighter, but he wasn't afraid to venture outside of Mexico for the first time here. And as you've been saying, it's fairly cagey this opening round. A decent looking jab there from Ramirez, just fell short.
He's got long arms, Ramirez, long levers, big long legs on him as well. You know, get him out of range quick, as he's just done there, little step out of range. And it is just a fear and out stage at the minute for both fighters. Ramirez has got a good jab, as you said. He landed it there and he looks capable. So to Burnett to try and break him down and to try and find the gaps.
Burnett just let it go with an overhand right through almost a right hand lead there just a few seconds before that. The first direct arena, great space for boxing. He'll be absolutely packed to the rafters later on for the arrival of Josh Warrington, but not just him. There's plenty of good fights on the card, really deep card, loads of fighters wanting on this one before the kind of unofficial summer break over August. Ramirez again just keeping that upper body on the move.
He's not been bad, Ramirez. He looks pretty dangerous. You know, he's trying the counters. He's landed a decent overhand right. He's landed a good jab. You can see a little bit of reddening around Burnett's eyes where he's probably took a stiff jab to the nose. Burnett's been in control. It's been nothing to really phone home about, and it really has been a fear and out round.
Well, Burnett had an excellent amateur career, 98 fights, 94 wins. First put on gloves at the age of just 4 years old. His final amateur fight was about was a defeat to Michael Conlon. That was the Irish flyweight final. Conlon off to the Olympic Games in Rio, part of a strong Irish team heading over there, strong GB team as well. As Burnett just closes in on the ropes, no knockdown signal there by Victor Loughlin. Just a slight slip from Ramirez as he tried to step away to his right-hand side. He was under a bit of pressure there, though.
His foot's caught one of the advertising Toblerones on the side of the ring. It happens a lot. Again, though, you can see what I meant before about the big long legs. Just trying to take that little step out of range to nullify Burnett's work. And he's been doing okay with it so far. Burnett's just got to be careful of not falling short because he is pretty tall, Ramirez.
Both looking very good condition. Both came in at 8 stone, 5 pounds. Just a couple of ounces between the two of them. Burnett just switching into the southpaw stance, looking for the left hand. And Ramirez again just tries to, or manages to find an exit route on the way to his right hand side. Falls just slightly short with the jab. Burnett coming in a little bit square, is maybe just trying to get onto the inside here, inside that left hand, and get to work.
Starting to find the target now, Burnett. slipping, switching southpaw as well. Ramirez isn't holding his shape as well as he was in the first round. It seems to be a bit early in the fight to say he's fallen apart, but he's let it go a little bit this round, and Burnett's had a bit of success now.
Burnett just stamping with that front foot, feinting with it, trying to draw something from Ramirez. If he can, who again just tries to keep those shoulders on the move. Burnett does exactly the same thing. You see the back foot just come off the canvas there of Ramirez as he throws that backhand, that right hand, just the weight coming slightly forward. Burnett, I think, just trying to draw him on here if he can.
Again, you know, they say a lot of fighters from gyms fight alike, and although they may not fight the same, they do similar movements and similar, you know, routines. And just caught with a little right hand there. Burnett, he needs to tighten up a little bit. You know, that feint and bit of pressure with the front foot, and, you know, feint to attack with the front foot is a typical Adam Booth fighter style of fighting, and the way they fight, you know, open you up with feints and always keep your opponent guessing all the time. Never just stop still and stay static. That's what Burnett's doing here. You know, good head movement, a little feint here and there, and then go for the attack.
Look for the right to the body there, just managed to sneak it in behind the forearm there of Ramirez, who's got quite long levers and then the fairly short upper body, so not easy to find the target. Left hand there from Burnett as well towards the end of the round. Well, into the third round of this one, scheduled for 10 between Ryan Burnett in the green and white and Cesar Ramirez of Mexico in the green and yellow. Burnett building on a steady first round with a more impressive second round. This is the defense of his WBC international bantamweight title that he won in his previous fight against Anthony Satul. And just looks like he's getting the measure of Cesar Ramirez. The hookup with Adam Booth, we've been talking about the trainer, came via the same person who put him in touch with Andy Lee, Damien McCann, a boxing man who Adam Booth has a lot of respect for. He told me yesterday, recommended that the two of them get together, as he did with the middleweight, and it's proved to be a good combination so far. Another fighter that's joined the stable recently, Mitchell Smith, has been sparring with Burnett, who just collected a left hand there from Ramirez as he tried to work his way onto the inside.
Started well this round, Burnett. Very first shot he threw was a left screw shot, landed perfect. Finding the target a little bit more freely now. Just shipped one, as you say, little left hook inside as he was coming in and switched off for the second, but right back to it now, dictating. This is what I like about, again, Adam Booth type fighter. He's dictating without doing anything. You know, he's just little movements and little threatening movements with the front foot and with the upper body leaning in, just little sharp feints. And he's not doing anything, but he's making Ramirez work. He's making him circle around. He's keeping him guessing all the time, but he's doing nothing in the meantime and conserving a lot of energy.
Well, that kind of ability to set the tempo is absolutely key, isn't it? If you can fight at your pace, then it just gives you such a kind of advantage. We were talking about this yesterday, actually, at the weigh-in briefly, and that was exactly the point that Booth was making, was that really good fighters can set that rhythm, but then when they need to change a rhythm, they can also do that, because that's something often that people really struggle with if you get into that kind of groove. Well, we're talking about Frampton Quigg, actually. Nice right hand there from Burnett.
I was just going to mention Frampton. His countryman tonight, similar weight class. You know, the key to that fight tonight for me will be who can control the pace, and Burnett's doing a good job of controlling the pace in this fight. You know, he took the center of the ring from the start. He's not chasing Ramirez around willy-nilly, just trying to land shots. It's a good control performance.
Again, just fighting with that backhand that time. Ramirez just tries to pop out the jab. A stream of encouragement coming from the Mexican corner. Again, just throws the right hand and just moves in behind it. Ends up on Burnett's shoulder, the weight coming just a little bit forward. He tries to come in.
Good body shot from Ramirez there.
Landed nicely, didn't it, with the right hand, as Burnett was just trying to come in with his own right. The trainer's target for Burnett by the end of this year was to be ranked in the top 15 with all of the governing bodies.
Round four.
Gracias. big bantamweight clash on the undercard of Kell Brook against Gennady Golovkin at the O2 on September the 10th between Lee Haskins, the IBF champion, and Stuart Hall. It's a rematch, actually. They met earlier on in their careers. Haskins got the better of it on that occasion. And the plan could be that if Burnett has another couple of fights after this one, so long as everything goes well tonight, as it is so far, then he could fight the winner of that. And I tried to get something out of the trainer yesterday about that. They're always reluctant to look too far ahead, but in terms of schedule and where he is at the minute, they feel that that's perfectly possible.
It isn't. 3 years now he's been a pro, and at the lower weights they obviously move a lot quicker. You know, they move fast, and 13 fights, this is his 14th tonight, and you know, 15th fight, you're talking about fighting for a title against a top opponent, and that's how it goes at the lower weights. But they know that when they turn pro and they train accordingly.
Well, you look at the likes of Charlie Edwards on that same card. He's going to have a world title shot against Casimiro, his 6th, 7th pro fight. Of course, Lomachenko's picked up 2 world titles in his first 7 fights. He's not really the yardstick that everybody should be measured by, but no. As you say, Nowarunua, he picked up 2 in his first 8 fights. So, as you mentioned, they can move a lot faster at the lower weights. And Burnett again there, just moving the head nicely as he just got into range and looked for the right to the body.
Yeah, especially if you're a good amateur, as Burnett was. And you know, the fighters that you mentioned, then obviously you're right saying, you know, Lomachenko isn't a yardstick for anyone. He fought for the WBO title in his 2nd fight, didn't he, when he turned pro? And that's phenomenal. That's unheard of. You know, you won't get many fighters doing that again. They won't stay amateur for that long now. Still trying to land with the sneaky shots, you know. Feinting the jab, come round with the left hook, Burnett, and same with the right. He goes to the body and then comes over, or he feints to the head and goes down with a right hand to the body. Pretty cagey, Ramirez, though. The long levers and the height of him making it difficult for Burnett.
He's not given much away, has he? He's difficult to hit to the body, as you say, because of those long arms. He can just tuck those elbows in, and there's really no target exposed, and he's not been easy to find to the head either. That was nice work, though, from Burnett. Leaping into that left hook and then looking for the left of the body, a left uppercut almost, and just stepping off to the side. He works all points of the compass, doesn't he? He's around that clock face, as they say. Ramirez at the start of the 5th round there, he was taking every single available second on his stool. Burnett was up off the stool over in the blue corner pretty quickly. Just a bit of whispered advice in the ear for Burnett from Adam Booth. Ramirez comes out with a little bit more aggression at the start of the round. Ramirez in the yellow and green, Burnett in the white and green. Looking for that uppercut again, right hand followed by the uppercut.
I could hear Adam Bird shouting then out of the corner, you know, when he come out swinging Ramirez, that's where he's at. And I'm wondering if he means that where he's at, as in a lot of fighters come out and give the last hurrah, they come out and have a right good goal before, you know, when they know that the tide's turned too much in their favour, and they'll come out and give it a good goal and have sort of emptied the tank and see what the fighter's got in front of you, where they can last the pace.
Nice jab there from Burnett. Caught Ramirez. Ramirez again just copping a left to the body there too. Burnett just gradually beginning to find the target more and more, just breaking him down. A bit of a wild right hand, followed by a good stiff jab there, yeah, from Ramirez. He needs to get on that a bit more, maybe.
Yeah, we noticed that from the first bell, didn't we? You know, you said that yourself. He's got a good stiff jab, Ramirez, and the length of his arms, he should be using a hell of a lot more.
Victor Lachlan just telling Ramirez that he's turning his back, and that's why he got hit on the back of the head there. And Burnett again just trying to dig away to the body, and Ramirez is having more of a go in this round, which does make me think that your assessment is probably right.
It could be, you never know. He could just finally kick into gear and think, you know what, there's only 5 rounds to go after this. We're halfway there, let's go. I'd like to see more 1-2s from Ramirez. If he's going to have any success, you know, the 1-2 is going to be the key for him. He's thrown it once already in this round. He needs to get a few more, because there's no point in having a big, long, stiff jab if you're not going to put anything on the end of it. It's not going to be enough on its own.
When he has thrown the backhand, a lot of the time he's overbalanced a bit and the weight's kind of come forward, but it could be a shot to nothing in a way, can't it? Because if you just move forward with it onto the shoulder, then it's difficult really to counter it.
It is. It's a better round for Ramirez. obviously his best round so far, but it's the first time he's actually come and had a good go at it and let some shots go with a bit of intention.
A really interesting fight this out to purse bids that has been asked for by the board is Ryan Burnett against Paul Butler for the British bantamweight title. That would be a very interesting one, to say the least.
Tough, tough fights for the British title. You know, if you're Ryan Burnett and you're sitting there as champion on the board over Paul Butler against your former world champion, you know, it's a tough fight for the British title, and it's whether any promoter is going to bid the right money for that type of fight, because that's a world title fight down the line.
Well, into the sixth, Ryan Burnett, defending champion holder of that WBC International Bantamweight title from Belfast in the green and white, Cesar Ramirez, venturing outside of his homeland of Mexico for the first time in the yellow and green. Brought a record of 12 wins and 2 defeats, the 2 defeats coming against good quality fighters.
Let's go, come on, Ramirez, let's go.
He's looked for that leaping left hook a few times, hasn't he? Just leading with that left hook.
He has, and the more rounds go by and the more tired and fatigued that Ramirez gets, that right hand will start dropping. It's landed on the glove every single time he's thrown it, Burnett. About 5 times this round, he's tried the same shot. He's mixing it up as well, though. Every now and then he'll feint and come down to the body with a left hook as well.
Ramirez on the jab. Burnett just trying to follow in that jab with the right hand. Ramirez trying to work to the body as they're in close. Full short with that right hand, left to the body there from Burnett was thrown with a bit of venom, and again just closes in, a kind of overhand right just fell slightly short. What can he do here, do you think, to maybe put him under slightly more sustained pressure?
I think Burnett, he's putting Ramirez under pressure without doing anything, and I said that a couple of rounds back, and I like it about him, it's pinching a rest without doing anything, but making the fighter think that you're doing something. You're controlling and dictating from the center of the ring with your feet and little feints with your feet and make him move around you. If you watch Burnett, you know, it should go revert to type and same again. After he stops throwing, he'll hold the center of the ring and he'll feint with his feet, and Ramirez will back off and will move around and think that Burnett is actually working hard. But he's put his foot on the gas a little bit here, Burnett, and he's had to because he's caught a few counters as well.
Just tipping at the waist there, Burnett, trying to keep that head moving. Ramirez let his left and right go and only really caught him with a couple of glancing blows. It drew some encouragement from the corner men away to our right-hand side, and Ramirez so far has looked solid. He's a decent, well-schooled fighter. He's come in shape as well, which you'd have to do because there was a weight limit to be made, and on the evidence of this, you wouldn't be all that surprised if we saw him again.
He's given a good account of himself so far, and he's come here. He's come here to have a go at it, and that's what you want from fighters coming into this country. Ryan Burnett's going to get a challenge, going to get a defence of his British title against the challenger who's been a world champion, who's a top fighter himself, and Paul Butler. It's a bit too much risk for too little reward, in my opinion. I don't think that's a fight that's going to be made for the British title. I think that's one further down the line.
Well, Victor Lachlan just having a quick word with Cesar Ramirez at the start of the round here. Just talking to him about turning his back and turning away from Burnett, who was just ordered back towards the neutral corner. Interested to see if Burnett just tries to click through the gears a bit in these final few rounds. He's done some rounds in his last couple of fights. He's been the distance both times against Jason Booth, then against Anthony Sartor. Back into the southpaw stance now. Burnett just threatening to throw that backhand and then does.
Comfortable as the southpaw as well, Burnett. It's nice to see. It's not many people's cup of tea, but if you can do it, then by all means use it as an asset, use it in your favor. Back to southpaw again.
again, just stamping almost with that front foot, just trying to get Ramirez to come forward. A quick shake of the head there from Burnett. Loss of balance there as he moved away to his right-hand side, then a slight slip as well over in the red corner.
That's twice he's had the same combination now, from a southpaw stance, throw a backhand, come left hook, switch to orthodox, and then chop a big right hand down as well. It's almost worked for them twice now.
Ramirez just stooping and looking for the right hand to the body, backs Burnett up in the corner and lets his hands go, mostly caught on the gloves. Again, the right hand there, and Burnett just trying to usher him in. Ramirez just dropping the hands, swaying back to taking the weight back, managed to just stay out of range, and Burnett not unhappy with the fact that the Mexican wanted to engage a little bit more there, and he stayed in that neutral corner deliberately. He could have removed himself if he wanted to.
If you're comfortable there, you're a good counter puncher, which Burnett's been throwing nice counters as well, and you want to be there, you want to fight it open up to you.
Ramirez just trying to ditch a right hand over the top, and there's a left of the body there from Burnett. A smile again from Ramirez. Slightly slow, lazy looking jab there from Ramirez, but Burnett wasn't able to capitalize on it. There's never been too much distance between these two. Burnett's been the one moving in for the most part, trying to close that gap, but Ramirez has been happy enough to stand almost within punching range. As we say, at times he's snapped that jab out, but it's probably something he could have done a bit more.
Good jab from Burnett.
Bell goes at the end of the round. So into the eighth, Victor Lachlan just having a quick word with Ramirez again there at the start of the round about turning his back. It is something you see fighters do every now and again. It can be quite problematic for referees to deal with. And Ramirez again just has come forward a little bit more at the start of the round, and Burnett has retreated almost to that neutral corner. Happy, as he said before, just to stand his ground there, just try and slip bob and weave on the inside and maybe make some angles and gaps for himself that way.
Good work from Burnett in the corner. Good little sharp counters. Making Ramirez make mistakes and then making them pay as well. Almost again, Ramirez turning his back a little bit. You're right what you say at the start of the round. Your point was very valid. You know, it's tough for the referee because a fighter could be hit on the back of the head or the side of the head, but if he's turning into it, he's turning away from it, sorry, and then he gets caught because he turns away, then it's technically, you know, you can't warn the fighter for throwing a shot. A fighter's throwing a shot to a target. If you've turned your head away and it's landed not on the target, you can't really criticize the fighter for doing so.
But that just closed in there, and Ramirez just slung a right hand at him, just delivered from low. It didn't miss by a lot, but to be honest, when fighters do miss against Burnett, they often don't miss by much, but there's a lot of science behind that. It's no coincidence. He's that kind of fighter, relies on those reflexes, has the hands low.
Burnett's just landed the left hook we were talking about a couple of rounds ago, where he's faking the jab and then coming round with a left hook. And I said a couple of rounds ago, fatigue will set in soon. And that right hand that's been catching the left hook of Burnett all night will drop. And at the first one, just landed clean on the chin of Ramirez, and he took it well.
Again, just using that front foot, just putting pressure on with the front foot, as you've been describing, always just inching forward. Ramirez threw that right hand, and then as he tends to, just wandered in behind it a bit. Left hand to the body there from Burnett, as he was being encouraged to turn his hips there from Adam Booth, and he's finding a home for that left to the rib cage more and more every now and again. And Ramirez just looking to unload a little bit, and Burnett not unhappy with that. It can be a dangerous thing to do. I was watching some highlights of Adonis Stevenson's fight from last night earlier on, and Williams, as he was on the ropes, was just trying to throw an uppercut, and Stevenson clipped him with a beautiful left hand.
when you're looking at Bennett in the corner, there's nothing landing from Ramirez. Nothing's finding a target, really. They're all swinging arm shots, and even the power shots, they seem to be going astray or being blocked by Bennett. And then he's coming back with nice counters, especially to the body. Good, clever stuff. Difficult one, that.
Well, I was going to say that the referee was probably going to signal no knockdown there. A little bit surprised to see the count.
Difficult one by the law of the land, it's a knockdown, but you could see he was off balance at the time when he got caught as well. A little bit harsh on Ramirez there, but by the law, it was a knockdown.
So into the ninth, two to go. Ryan Bennett well on top here in the green and white against Cesar Ramirez of Mexico in the yellow and green. Bennett defending that WBC international bantamweight title he won last time out, and he's going to keep that one firmly around his waist. The WBC champion is Shinsuke Yamanaka. You look down the list, Jamie McDonald features, of course, as does Lee Haskins. Roshi Warren picked up the WBA super title against Carlos Payano just, well, two or three weeks ago. Triple Olympian Roshi Warren didn't have the greatest of times at the Olympic Games, but he's managed to get himself a world title.
It's been difficult for Bennett to break this fighter down, Ramirez, and the names you mentioned on that list, and fighters who are champions for the, who hold the other belts, they're going to be a lot more difficult than these fighters to beat, but they will leave themselves open a little bit more, because they'll be coming to win a hell of a lot more than Ramirez has tonight and have a bit more quality about them. But you know, the level will rise for Bennett, and he has to adapt and rise with that as well.
He just came onto a right hand there, Bennett, as he was moving his head on the way in. He's got his head on Ramirez's shoulder, just trying to push down on the slightly taller man and bring what he probably feels is, despite the height difference, a difference in physical strength between the two to bear if he can.
If you want to be overly critical and over picky, there is some things what he needs to work on, Bennett. There has been some times where he's been caught with shots, especially like that. You know, counters when he's lunging in, which a better fighter and a higher level fighter will capitalize on that. But at the stage he's at the minute and the level that he's progressing at, this has been a decent opponent and a decent night to work for him so far.
Ramirez is putting 2-3 punches together there, looking for the body. He managed to drop the elbows on the mainly low Bennett, and again just weaving his way in, throws the right hand, looks for that left hook.
Body shot there from Bennett.
Right on the border. There was nothing wrong with it, but it was
short to very high though from Ramirez, aren't he? So I think that waistband should be fair game.
Ramirez has tried to quicken up the feet a bit there as he pursued Bennett across the ring. He's a very elusive, slippery kind of target. Touch the gloves between the two, 10th and final round. It's been another good outing here for Ryan Bennett. Right hand there to kick things off, and maybe he's going to look to try and finish with a bit of a flourish here in the final 3 minutes. It would take something pretty special, I think, to get Ramirez out of there, because he's never looked really rocked at any stage, and there's some good work there from Ramirez, actually, just on the ropes.
Yeah, you're right. He landed a good uppercut inside and a little left hook straight after it, which good body shot again. He's come at me in a business this round, Ramirez.
Bennett just launching in with that left hand again, this time to the body. You mentioned Stewie Hall over on the far side of the ring, up against Lee Haskins on the 10th of September. He's trained by Max McCracken these days, Stewie Hall, and there's plenty of them on the bill. And that was a nice combination there from Bennett. Left hand followed by a right, the sweat spraying off the head there of Ramirez. Kamal Yafai will be seeing a little bit later on. Frankie Gavin as well. Stable mates of Stewie Hall. Good, solid-looking left hand. The one we've been talking about got through that time.
Good stuff from Burnett there. Ramirez really come out meaning business at the start of the round and took the first 30, 45 seconds on you know, working hard and really putting his eggs in one basket. But Burnett seemed to put manners on him. Oh, lovely right uppercut inside from Burnett. Seemed to put manners on him now and got the fight firmly back in his favour. The round, sorry, firmly back in his favour and under his control.
Stung him with a really nice southpaw jab as well, just before he landed that uppercut. A few uppercuts to the body in there as well, two or three of them, and there's certainly nothing wrong with the stamina, fitness or gas tank of Ryan Burnett. He showed us that over his last few performances with the rounds that he's put in. Just got clipped by a right hand, but then threw a big overhand right himself there. Burnett working away to the body again. I think Ramirez is beginning to feel these a bit as Burnett just wraps up his left hand. Into the final minute, Burnett just letting go with the right. Did miss by a lot again. Just happy to sit in the corner and see whether Ramirez will open up, and the Mexican does duly oblige. But the defense is good.
Good right uppercut from Ramirez. He just sort of slipped onto that one there, Burnett. Needs to just be a bit more careful.
Into the final few seconds, and this will go the full 10 round distance. Ryan Burnett will hold on to this WBC International Bantamweight good title with some comfort. And there goes the bell. So, a good performance there from Burnett, but Cesar Ramirez played his part.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have our judges score totals. Judge Bella Florian sees the contest 100-89. Both judges, Juan Carlos Paleo and John Keane, 99-90 in favour of the winner, and still the BBC International Bantamweight Champion, Ryan Burnett. And ladies and gentlemen, please, your appreciation for the challenger from Mexico, Cesar Ramirez.
Ryan, well done. Was that a useful 10-round experience against a sometimes tricky and awkward opponent?
Yeah, he was tough. Hit him with a couple of shots. He was tough, and it's all experience, you know. At the level I'm at now, things like that is what you need. Well, I think anyway, and getting experience like that with a tough Mexican is priceless.
How far away do you think you are from world title shot? A lot of people sort of asking that question now and putting you on the verge of that mix.
A lot of people are saying I'll be a world title shot soon for Ryan. Personally, I think I've got a bit more to learn. You know, I'm not one of these people who's just going to start calling out people and think they're something that they're not. I'm in the gym every day. I'm learning. I'm dedicated to the boxing, and I'll keep learning. And when the time's right, I'm sure Adam will know, and then we'll take it from there.
Yeah, you mentioned it there. What do you feel you still need to work on?
Just general ring craft. You know, that's I won't stop learning on that. And I think it's great to get the next them 10 rounds is what you need, is where you're learning, and thinking of a few of those, and I could be ready.